Tucked away in the northwest corner of the city lies Division II Philadelphia University, where Herb Magee has carved out a tradition of excellence since arriving on campus more than 50 years ago.
In Philadelphia, there have been a lot of great coaches, but Herb is known as the king.
Magee's journey to Philly basketball royalty began as a sharpshooting guard at famed West Catholic High.
Herb and I played together at high school. He had one scholarship, was called Philadelphia Textile at the time. He went about 3 miles from home to attend Textile and never left.
A two-time All-American, Magee remains the third leading scorer in school history. Though he was drafted by the Boston Celtics in 1965, he decided to stay at his alma mater as an assistant coach. In 1967, he got the top job. And 3 years later, he won a national championship.
Herb's 1970 team, they were hard-nosed, they were a really tough group, a tough-minded group, and I think they exemplified how Herb wanted to coach and how he wanted to approach the game.
Marcus, don't come to that! Can't be back there.
If you watch his teams run offense, it's extraordinary. All of us want our teams to be exact in their execution. Herb's teams do that game after game and year after year.
Magee also has channeled his competitive streak into his role as a premier shot doctor, working with everyone from up-and-coming players to NBA stars.
1 year he spoke at my camp, he made his first 77 when he was speaking. 77 in a row, you know, it's bop, 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 bop. Yeah, they all went in.
At first you get focused in on watching Herb make shots, then you have to focus in on the message. And if you want to put the ball in the basket, go to Herb Magee.
He has the ability to explain to a player how he can get on that track, because his eye sees things that the rest of us don't.
Everybody talks about Herb working with Charles Barkley, and it is true, he worked with Charles Barkley, half the day on his jumper and half the day on his golf swing. So Herb has to take some criticism for Charles' golf swing.
Over the years, Magee's success has attracted national attention and coaching opportunities in Division I and the NBA. But he couldn't be lured away from the school he calls home.
Herb's probably a little bit more secure than the rest of us. The rest of us were always looking for the next challenge and how we were going to conquer the world. And I think Herb had his own little world at Philadelphia University.
With win number 903, Herb achieved basketball immortality in 2010, passing Bob Knight to become the NCAA's all-division leader in career victories.
How much this means to our players and to the coaches. This is a wonderful, wonderful night, not just for Herb Magee and his family, but for the men's basketball team here at the university.
He is the same guy. He has the same energy. He loves teaching basketball, not just coaching basketball. And if somebody said to me, what do you think he'll be doing at 80 or 85? I think he's going to be coaching Philly U, racking up the wins.